By the way, I should tell you this segment of the show, brought to you by Dollar Shave Club. Watch the video that's gone viral here at the Dennis Miller Show. Hysterical. See it at dollarshaveclub.com, dollarshaveclub.com. And as I said, Joel's Greatest Hits now available digitally and on CD, and she'll be touring throughout the spring. So visit jeweljk.com for information on the album and upcoming tour dates. Jewel.
Oh, hi.
What's up, kiddo?
To me. Well, thank you.
What are you and Larry Mahan Astaire doing today? You going out and tripping the light fantastic?
We are. We just spend the day dancing. You guessed it.
I always, Joel, you're the most candid interview I have. I can't tell you when people pitching things come on how sometimes they're so robotic and you're always, other than not saying hello when you said hello to
them. Yeah, I like to just play a little hard to get. I know how you are.
Thank you, Joel. What a hipster. Cy Young Leno this week, baby. How was that? Chuckles Barkley makes me laugh a lot. Did you have time to share any time with him? He's funny.
Fun. We got to hang out just a little bit at the end. He seems really nice, has a good sense of humor.
Yeah, I was in a celebrity golf tournament with him once, and he was like the Pied Piper, worst golfer on the planet outside of me, but most people end up following him because he's a real deal. Let's talk about some of the hits on the Greatest Hits album. Is there's a duet with Kelly Clarkson?
Yeah, I recut some of the hits. So I redid Foolish Games with Kelly Clarkson, which was amazing. She's really a hoot. I don't know if you saw her Grammy acceptance speech on the Grammys, but that's exactly how she is. She's really funny and really down to earth.
Julia, you're probably, what are you, 17 now?
Is I
it
am.
Weird yeah. to look back on your
Almost
career?
Legal.
Huh? But, you know, it's so, you've had such a storied career, but God, you're still a kid to some degree. I don't even know how old you are now, but it seems like I first came across you musically, and you must have been in your mid-teens or something.
I was really young when I got signed. I was 18. And, you know, the cocaine and all that. I'm onto my Jesus phase now, so I think they're going to make a documentary about me soon.
I'm the only guy in the world I know who's never done blow, because I remember...
Yeah, you know, and I've never been stoned. I think I'm the only musician. I was telling somebody the other day, I'm like, I'm the only musician that's never, like, been high. It's unbelievable.
That's why there'll never be a After the Music special on you on VH1, where they say, and then Jewel said, I think we need more beer. You know, that, and then they go to the commercial break, and they come back, and it's ugly. Filming a video in L.A. this week. Anything you can tell us about it, or is it all on deep background, kiddo?
You know, I just went there and made a video for the track you were playing a little bit of, Two Hearts Breaking. I put a new song on the record just because I wanted to show people where I was at now. I put everything on the record in chronological order, so it starts at the beginning. I wrote Who'll Save Your Soul when I was, 16 years old, because I wanted to hitchhike through Mexico for spring break, like all parents hope their children do one day. And Who'll Save Your Soul was the result, and that started my career, and... I went chronologically in order, and then right up to a brand new song with Two Hearts Breaking.
Now, I'm sure when your kid comes to you and says he wants to go to Guadalajara on foot eventually, your son, you'll be happy about
that. Yeah, I know. I got to stop saying these stories so he doesn't think that they're cool. But luckily, whatever a parent does isn't cool, I'm sure. So.
Right. Well, I tell you, the kid will be rough and tumble, because I'm sure when Ty carries him around on his shoulders, he also bucks like a Brahma bull just to get the kid prepped for...
we don't want to raise any weenies around here.
There you go. Joel's on Twitter at JoelJK. And tell us about your charity, Project Clean Water. What do you got here, Joel?
I founded this when I was, back in 97. And when I was homeless, I had bad kidneys and I had to drink a gallon of clean water a day, and I couldn't afford it. And I thought, you know, if I ever get in a position to help, I will. And amazingly, my life turned around. And one of the first things I did was set up Project Clean Water, and we've put about 35 wells in 15 different countries, and we're still going strong.
You know what, kiddo? You got an authenticity that runs through that you can't You're a charmer, but you could never hide that. I mean, a lot of these charities, I wonder if people are phoning it in too, but what a sweet thing to do as a gesture to your past. I like you, Jewel.
I never even talked about it for the first, at least 12 years of the organization, and then I realized, and I just funded it myself, because like you say, so many celebrities, it seems like they do charities just for the publicity. And so I kind of just never really talked about it. But then I realized if I don't talk about it, I'm just denying more water to more people. And I just joined up with Virgin Unite and Voss Water Foundation, so this way we're able to help more. And it's been really great.
All right. Jewel's Greatest Hits, now available digitally. And we're old people now, Jewel. When we started out, we were on the Laserdisc and CD. JewelJK.com for information on the album, upcoming tour dates. Enjoy your day, kiddo. Say hi to the old man.
Thanks. I appreciate it. Nice talking with you, as always.
Later, Gator. I like Jewel. She seems sweet. Yeah.
Very
doesn't
sweet.
Seem like she has a phony bone in her body. Homelessness does that to you. Now, Christian, you told me that you were houseless as a kid. But you
yes.
never thought of it as homeless.
No, I didn't.
No matter where you set up shop with, I've met you. Who did I meet?
You've met my dad and my sister and my wife,
right.
And the rest of us. They just kind of linger in the shadows. You haven't met the rest of my family just yet.
Your wife and sister, do you confuse them periodically?
Not often, but once or twice, yeah.
Have hijinks ensued?
What?
Christian, tell Liev to get up on that chair, that he's the only one who can reach the bucket in the roof and put a red light
now,
in.
Now, I would have to let him out of his cage to do that. You don't want me to let him out of
Let's
his cage.
Get it on. Sugar. Come on over here, Liev. Rest your head on my shoulder. I've been really trying, baby, to fire.
Trying to hold back
your
feelings for so long.
But I figured out a way to
like
discontinue his occupation. My show.
You're the best, Dennis.
Fire him! During a makeout session.
Yes, love, baby.
All right. Not the man I used to be. 866-509-RANT is our phone number. 866-509-7268. We are, how many hours are we into the show today? Four?
Yeah, this is the fifth hour. We're doing a Lars Larson special.
Sometimes you just need to put the paddles on a segment, reinvigorate it, get it spiking again. Helen in Memphis, voicemail number 6.
Love you guys. Love Thank your program.
Whoa,
I feel
whoa,
like
whoa.
Your older sister because I've got a brother 11 years younger. He's about your age. Bye, and just love you guys.
Hey, whoa. Can we do a show etiquette thing here?
Sure.
Please play that again, and let me point out where this is wrong on a bunch of levels.
Love you guys.
Well,
love your
right there, I can stop it. No plural compliments needed here.
Well, she thought
is
that...
Is that a T-shirt?
She thought that she
is
was
that a T-shirt before we go? Because I'll forget what we're talking about.
No, it's not.
Okay.
She addressed you as you guys because she thought you had the Ray Milland head.
Right.
So
or all. At least multi-phrenic personalities.
Well, there's that, too.
Right.
Love you. Love your program. I feel like you're older.
Good work.
Because I've got a brother 11 years younger. He's about your age. Bye, and just love you.
If you'd like to order a Dennis Miller Home R Scalpel, you can go to our website right now. Is it scalpel or scalpel? And the medical instrument.